Today, I'm going to review two papers about STAT signaling in breast cancer. The two papers were published in this same year at the same journal, Clinical Cancer Research. The first paper, STAT signaling in different breast cancer subtypes, focused on the different STAT signaling in different subtypes of breast cancers. And the second paper compared STAT3 and STAT5 in their distinct roles in the pathogenesis and targeted therapy of breast cancer. Breast cancers are classified as four major subgroups according to the existence of estrogen or progesterone receptor and human epidermal growth factor receptor 2, HER2. At first, ER or PR-positive breast cancers are called the luminal subtype. Using gene expression profiling, the ER-positive subtype can be further divided into two luminal A and B subtypes and triple-negative breast cancer cells. TNBC can be additionally categorized into six different subtypes. The paper compared expression and activity of different STAT family members in different subtypes of breast cancers. At first, in ER-positive breast cancers, STAT1, 3, and 5A and 5B are all expressed, and STAT2, 4, 6 are expressed in ER-positive breast cancer cell lines. One study reported that STAT5A and B positive cancers demonstrated a better prognosis with a higher response rate to endocrine therapy and longer survival rate to endocrine therapy and longer survival after relapse. In contrast, there were no associations between STAT3 expression and response to therapy or prognosis in this paper. Many other papers also supported the positive correlation between STAT5 expression and improved response to endocrine therapy in ER-positive breast cancer. In ER-negative HER2-positive breast cancers, STAT3 has been reported to be associated with HER2 amplification. Among possible pathways between STAT3 and HER2, leptin is also known to induce increment of HER2 through STAT3 signaling. In triple-negative breast cancers, STAT1, 3, and 5 are expressed. STAT1 gene expression in TNBC indicates a better prognosis. Meanwhile, reducing STAT3 activation and metformin reduces growth of TNBC cell lines. It could be interpreted as STAT3 is related to TNBC cell growth. Also, there is a paper suggesting that STAT2, STAT5 inhibition and PI3 kinase mTOR dual targeting can be a good therapeutic strategy to treat TNBC. Among STAT family, downregulation of STAT3 and 5AB by different agents is associated with reduced growth in breast cancer cell lines, suggesting that these molecules could serve as therapeutic targets across breast cancer subtypes. The next paper deals with STAT3 and STAT5, specifically about their relationship in pathogenesis in breast cancers. STAT3 have been known to have oncogenic activation in various types of cancers. In breast cancers, STAT3 is most often associated with triple-negative breast cancers. Mostly, it is activated by interleukin-6 in breast cancer, and continued activation of STAT3 target genes lead to malignant behavior. The upregulation of target genes by STAT3 promote the protection from apoptosis, proliferation of cancer cells, and lead invasion and angiogenesis. Furthermore, serine phosphorylated STAT3, which can be found in the mitochondria, can promote the survival of breast cancer cells solely through its effect on mitochondrial function. STAT5 also has been found to be constitutively activated in breast cancers. As I mentioned earlier, STAT5 activation is more frequently found in hormone-responsive tumors, ER-positive breast cancers. Prolactin is the cytokine which is the main physiological trigger for activating STAT5 in mammary gland, but high circulation levels of prolactin are associated with cancer risk in ER and PR-positive tumors. However, activating the prolactin receptor in mesenchymal-like breast cancer cells reduced invasion. STAT3 and STAT5 are both have positive association with breast cancers. However, there are several reports that suggest STAT3 and STAT5 have distinct and opposing function in breast cancer when they both exist in the same cells. 7% of breast cancer have only active STAT5 while 40% have active STAT3 only. Also, 30% of breast cancers have both active STAT3 and STAT5. Tumors with active STAT3 only have poor prognosis and is more often in triple-negative breast cancers, which are more malignant than other subtypes. Interestingly, tumors with activation of both STATs have better features than STAT3 alone activation. There are many researches supporting the mechanisms of STAT5 opposing to STAT3 function. STAT5 oppositely regulates STAT3 function through three major ways. They can directly regulate target genes in opposite way with STAT3. STAT5 also can upregulate negative regulators of STAT3 such as SOX. In addition, STAT3 and STAT5 also regulate a distinct set of genes that may promote opposing functions. Therefore, targeting STATs for the treatment of breast cancer is important, because STAT3 is activated in 70% of breast tumors, inhibiting STAT3 might be potentially important. Instinctively, STAT3 can be inhibited by its upstream inhibitor, such as JAK inhibitors. Recently, JAK2 inhibitor has shown efficacy against the growth of TNBC xenografts containing activation of STAT3. Also, we can inhibit STAT3 by STAT3 dimerization inhibitors, because STAT3 has to be dimerized to transcriptionally regulate target genes. Targeting the SH2 domain to block the STAT3 dimerization and signaling transduction could be a possible way to block STAT3 function. Inhibition of STAT5 is similar to STAT3. Using JAK inhibitor can have dual benefit of blocking both STAT pathways. However, as I told previously, STAT5 have a suppressive effect on STAT3's oncogenic functions when they both STAT3 exist together. So targeting STAT5 alone could remove the suppressive effect of that STAT5 has on STAT3. Therefore, to use STAT5 inhibitor, knowing the activation status of both STAT5 and STAT3 would be important. Up to now, I talked about the status of STATs in different subtypes of breast cancers. In conclusion, STAT1, 3, 5 expression can be found in all breast cancer subtypes. Especially STAT5 tend to be more associated with ER-positive breast cancers, while STAT3 are linked to more aggressive triple-negative breast cancers. STAT5 activation is linked to a more favorable prognosis, including a positive response to tamoxifen therapy in ER-positive breast cancers. Also, STAT5 opposes many of the functions of STAT3 on both the molecular and biological level. And to conclude, targeting STATs is an attractive rational molecular strategy for breast cancer therapy when we know their expression status in the cancer.